Hello viewers, I'm Rohit Khurana from Intellect Digest. In this video, I'm going to give you a detailed review of the Huawei Ascend Y300, which is their latest budget dual-core phone. Comes with promising specifications. It is one of the best sellers in its category and is currently out of stock on Indian online market stores. It has some interesting features to offer at the price point at which it is placed. So let's get started. Starting with the size of the phone, it has a 4-inch display at front. Talking of the thickness level, it is 11.2 millimeters, which is not too thick. The build quality seems good. Let me show you around the hardware. So on front you have this 4-inch screen, 3 capacitive buttons just below the screen. On the top you have the normal speaker mesh, a VGA front facing camera here. On the right hand side you have a volume rocker. On the left side you have a micro USB port for data transfer and charging. On top you have a power or wake up key. And in the middle on top you have a 3.5 mm standard audio jack. Bottom is clean with a small mic hole over here. The back has a 5 megapixel camera with autofocus and flash. There is a speaker mesh just on the side of the camera. Nicely designed, the back is kind of rubberized with textured finish, so it is anti-slip and looks good, scratch resistant, so it's a nice feature. Let me open the back flap and show you what lies beneath. So there is a battery of 1730 mAh which should last for at least one full day of usage. The rated talk time is 5 hours on 3G. There is a SIM card slot over here and micro SD card slot over here, with which you can increase the memory by further 32GB micro SD card. The internal memory of the Huawei Ascend Y300 is 4GB. It is a single SIM phone and does not come with the dual SIM option. The user interface is the Huawei Emotion UI, which is very different from what you will find on conventional Android phones. This one runs the Android Jelly Bean 4.1, and the Emotion UI changes the screens like you are turning the pages of a book, and it has all the apps etc. on the home screen itself, so there is no different app screens. They are all organized here on the home screen, and you can make folders to keep them organized. Just like I put one icon, drag it into the other and it becomes a folder, just like you have it on iOS. So it is very neat and very easy to understand. There is a dock over the bottom, so 4 icons will stay here and rest all will remain on the pages, so you will get multiple pages. This is the Emotion UI. Talking about the display, the quality of display and the color reproduction is very impressive. As you can see, the colors are coming out to be really nice. Let me check the brightness levels. So we had it on minimum brightness earlier, so turning the brightness it becomes even more vibrant. So let me turn it to automatic mode so that, yeah, so colors are vibrant. The sharpness of the display is fairly good. The display resolution is 480 by 800, which is QHD, and with 4-inch screen it gives a pixel per inch density of 233. Let me also demonstrate to you the camera quality of this phone. So let's click a few shots here. It is a nice touch to focus camera and it is focusing well on click. You can also zoom in. Let me show you a picture which I just clicked, and the picture has come out to be fairly sharp. The text is also readable, but beyond a certain zoom level it is not very clear. You can shoot stills with a resolution of 5 megapixel, and you can also record videos at 480p but not high definition, which is QHD resolution to be precise. Let me also playback a video to show you the quality of the video playback on this device and the volume levels.
Hello viewers, I'm Rohit Khurana from Intellect Digest. Today I'm going to give you some quick tips and tricks of the Samsung Galaxy Note 2.
So as you can see, the vibrance of the colors in the video is coming out to be good, as well as the sound levels are also fairly decent, if not excellent. So for video consumption, the display does a very good job with a vibrant screen, and the sound output is good, so you can consume videos, you can do gaming and stuff. I'll quickly show you some gaming as well. So let's jump to gaming directly. So let's run Temple Run 2, which is one of the hot favorites these days. Right now the volume is turned to maximum. The maximum volume is not too loud, but it is easily audible. So the motion sensor is working good, and the touch inputs are also doing fine. The screen is fairly responsive, and there are no noticeable lags in the gameplay when it comes to Temple Run 2. Although it is not a very heavy game, we'll run a few more games to show you the performance of gaming. So let's get out of this game. Let's try Racing Moto. So on basic games it is doing fine. You can play almost all the entry level and mid level games. Since this phone has decent specification, it has 1 GHz dual core processor, 512 MB of RAM, so you can play most of the light games and mid level games, but not the higher end games, since the RAM requirements for heavy games is usually higher. While we are testing some benchmarks, let me also talk a little bit about the specifications of this phone. The Huawei Ascend Y300 is powered by a 1 GHz dual core processor, has 512 MB of RAM, 4GB internal memory. You can add a micro SD card of up to 32GB to increase the memory further. Talking of the graphics, it has an Adreno GPU, which is the Adreno 203. The CPU architecture of the 1 GHz processor is Cortex A5. It is not top of the line, but it is not too bad either, considering that the price point of this phone is around $160 or 8000 rupees. The AnTuTu benchmark score of the Huawei Ascend Y300 comes out to be close to 6000, which is again not high end but not bad. The CPU score is 2000, the RAM score is 909, GPU score is 2513, and the I/O score is 485. Let us also run the Quadrant Standard benchmark and see how it performs on the Quadrant Standard. So on Quadrant Standard it scores 1576, which is also a mediocre score, but again we don't complain. Let's also run Nina Mark 2 benchmark to show you the graphics performance and what is the frames per second it renders. So let's start. The Nina Mark 2 score has come out to be 33.2 frames per second, which is not bad for normal multimedia consumption and moderate gaming. Talking of the color options and box contents, the Huawei Ascend Y300 comes in two colors, the white and black. The one we are testing here is black in color. Along with the phone, you also get a standard USB wall charger, a USB to micro USB data cable, and a standard 3.5mm earphone headset with this phone. At a price point of under 8000 rupees, a phone with dual camera capable of also doing video calling using the front VGA camera, with latest Android Jelly Bean, with Emotion UI, butter smooth graphics, beautiful looking screen, a compact form factor, easy to hold, nice battery life. It is all in all a very interesting and complete package in itself. It is not meant for heavy gamers since it is an entry level device, but for the price point at which it is offered, it really provides a very good value. This is all we have on a detailed review of the Huawei Ascend Y300. If you like our video, please press the like button below. For more such videos, please press the subscribe button below. This is Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.